Good evening, everybody, and welcome to Bard High School Class of 2022 graduation.
If I can follow our illustrious valedictorian, Kishelle Settle, I would like to follow up on her welcome to the Bard Class of 2022 graduation / commencement. This evening, we will honor the scholarship and hard work of our great eight, our second graduating class. Before we begin the festivities, however, I'd like to thank all of you for coming out to celebrate with us, with a special thanks to Mayor Bowser, Councilman Trayon White, Chancellor Farabee, Chief Bay, Instructional Superintendent Jellig, and thank you, an extra thank you to all of our funders and partners who make our work possible. But most of all, I want to thank you, the families of our graduates. Thank you for all you have done to nurture our students, to support us in supporting your students, and for sharing them with us for the last 2 years. And forgive the pause and delay, but please join me in welcoming Bard DC's Associate Dean of Studies and Literature Faculty, Dr. Nellie Lambert.
So, eight graduates, but more than eight awards here. And I'll read them in the order that they're piled. This award is from the Division of Language and Literature, the Arts and Humanities Award for Ari Cimarins. The Division of Arts Award Performance Category goes to Desiree Horn. The Division of Arts Award in the Visual Arts Category is for Kishelle Settle. Kishelle, stay up one more time, if you don't mind. The Division of Language and Literature, Spanish Language and Culture Award is for Kishelle Settle. The School Spirit Award is for Ari Cimarins. And the Division of Social Sciences, American Social Sciences Award for Ari Cimarins. The Citizenship Award and the Leadership Awards go to Leah Cormier. The High Honors Award And the Division of Mathematics and Science Chemistry Award go to Kishel Settle. Yeah! 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 Academic Achievement Award for Davida Bonaparte. And Academic Achievement Award for Kishel Settle, valedictorian. In addition, the Ward 7 Council has just awarded Kishel Settle a Book Scholarship Award. It is now my pleasure to introduce our keynote speaker, Roberto Rodriguez, who has dedicated his career in government and in the nonprofit sector to advancing education equity, access, and excellence. He is nationally recognized for his leadership in early childhood, K through 12, and post-secondary education policy, and for building multi-sector partnerships with educators, policymakers, school leaders, and communities to better respond to the needs of diverse learners. Currently, he serves at the White House in the Department of Education. Prior to his service there, he was senior education advisor and later chief counsel to late U.S. Senator Edward M. Kennedy. He began his career in Washington, D.C. at Unidos U.S., where he directed research and policy analysts of federal and state education issues. Rodriguez holds a bachelor's degree from the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor, and a master of education from the Harvard Graduate School of Education. Please welcome Roberto Rodriguez.
Thank you, Dr. Lambert. I am so pleased to be here with our graduates tonight. Let's give them a round of applause. Yes. Thank you, Dr. Anderson, for the chance to be with you tonight. Kishel, thank you for welcoming us. Big night for you. Big night for all of us. I want to begin with a heartfelt congratulations to our graduates. This is a momentous day. I hope you enjoy reflecting and relishing on all that you've accomplished. And I want to give a major shout out and a thanks to our beautiful families who are here celebrating with you tonight, to our moms and dads, our aunts and uncles, yes, our brothers, sisters, grandparents, all of our fans here in the audience. Their support and the support of your teachers has sustained you, these eight amazing graduates, gotten you to this day. You have so very much to be proud of tonight. You have endured a lot, graduates, to get you here this evening. Over the course of the past couple of years, you have witnessed the toll that dual pandemics have taken across our country and across the world and in our communities. This global pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, brought unprecedented disruption to all of us, right, to our And you have weathered that pandemic and the pandemic that we've seen, the impact of racism and racist systems on our programs and on our communities, the toll of both of these dual pandemics, right, to our mental health, to our well-being. You've adapted to virtual instruction. You've reacclimated to in-person learning. You've watched as our democracy has been tested before our very own eyes here in our own backyard here in Washington, D.C. You've seen challenges around the climate crisis grow more urgent with every passing day, and you've struggled, like all of us, to understand and make sense of how tragedies and gun violence, the impact that that's had, tragedies like Uvalde, Texas, have continued to bring time and time again to our country. And yet you have persisted, and you are here tonight. And you have demonstrated the survival tools, the instincts that have brought you here tonight. You've lifted yourselves up, and you've lifted one another up, and you've turned those obstacles, those challenges we've seen across the country, into opportunity. You have exercised your resiliency muscles in a way that no other group of graduates, no other graduating class, has had to exercise that level of resiliency. And most of all, you have believed in yourselves and in your future. And each of you is nothing short of amazing. Our mission is to live up to your highest aspirations, and to create an education system and a country that delivers opportunity for all. An education system that meets your full potential. And those values of equity and opportunity, they've been guideposts in my own life, in my own career. As the son of public school educators, as the son of immigrants, I've learned the importance of service, of community, of opening the door for those whose voices are seldom heard. And one of my heroes in my own life, Cesar Chavez, great organizer, farm worker, leader, he said of education, "Our ambitions must be broad enough to include the aspirations and the needs of others, not just of ourselves, for their sake and for our own." Bard's motto is a place to think. And no doubt you have grappled with the implications of these big, heavy events in your own lives. You've made time to process that in real time, make sense of it. Your great teachers have imparted on you the value of critical thinking, the value of civic discourse, the value of pushing one another, to learn from one another, to learn how to disagree and how to grow from that, all skills that you will use for the rest of your lives. And during your time at Bard, you've developed not just as scholars, but as citizens and as leaders. I cannot overstate how important your voice and your leadership is to the future success of our democracy. Your voice matters. Your leadership matters for our future. You are about to enter a phase in your lives that's largely defined by the limits of your own dreams. With the world at your fingertips, you can accomplish anything that you set your mind to. And each of you is an embodiment of hope, not just for your families and for the beautiful people celebrating you here tonight, but hope for our country, hope for a more perfect union that I know you are prepared to achieve. So do not be discouraged by the magnitude of issues that you see play out before you in your communities, in our country, every day. But take those issues and let those issues motivate you, inspire you to take up the baton to make a difference in your communities and in your world. One individual can truly make all the difference. You know, I am inspired by, and I often draw upon the words of a great statesman, someone who met with young people in South Africa and spoke out against apartheid, the late Robert Kennedy. And he said, quote, "Each time a man stands up for an ideal or acts to improve the lot of others or strikes out against injustice, he sends forth a tiny ripple of hope, and crossing from a million different centers of energy, those ripples build a current that can sweep down the mightiest walls of oppression and resistance. Sweeping down those walls and making that meaningful change, that is going to require on your part patience, persistence, incremental measures of progress. There are no shortcuts to real change. You know, in the fierce urgency of today and of our communities, we are often rewarded by short wins. But I've learned over the course of my career, it is about that patience, that persistence, and your values that will drive you forward. You know, I learned that from many great leaders that I've worked for, you know, for the late Senator Kennedy, when I was working for our President Barack Obama in the White House. You know, Senator Kennedy, he was a fierce negotiator. He stood up for values. He battled over what matters most, but he also forged tough compromises, and he always remained focused, not just on the objectives that he was trying to achieve in the legislation he was working on, but on his values. And I've learned that the problems that we confront today, they're resolved not just by our own convictions or the strength of our own beliefs, they are resolved and met through partnership, clarity of objective, an open heart and an open mind to work through differences. No one large problem is solved by one individual alone. And you will undoubtedly encounter some who are going to be skeptical. Skeptical of collaboration and compromise, skeptical of working together. I hope in those moments you will pause, you will breathe, you will remember to stay true to yourself, to have faith in yourself, to make your own decisions about when to give and when to stand your ground and move your values forward. And you will discover in those moments what it means to live your values. No matter the paths you pursue, your unique gifts and talents, they will bring great things to this world. And you will remain focused, I know, on your core values. You will live a life marked not just by your own achievements, but by the success and well-being of others that you touch around you. So I challenge you to be active participants in our democracy, to be dedicated stewards of our most fundamental values as a country, of fairness and equality, of justice, of dignity. Let your values give you the courage and persistence to pursue change, even when everything and everyone around you may say that it's not possible. Those values will serve as an extraordinary compass toward a better world, toward a stronger world, toward opportunity for yourselves and for your future. And so, I'm proud to serve in an administration that believes that education is the great equalizer, the first rung on our ladder of opportunity that defines our shared dreams as Americans. It is through education that those dreams are attainable. I wouldn't be standing here without it. That diploma that each of you will hold this evening, that associate's degree that you will hold this evening, that is a testament of the greatness of education in our lives and in our collective future. There are people in the world who will expect less from people who look like me, people who look like you, people who will try to count us out. You are already counting yourselves in. You're investing in yourselves, you're pushing yourself forward, you're reaching for more. You have tackled amazing obstacles. You've accomplished, you've earned that diploma, you've earned that associate's degree, you've pushed yourself to be here this evening. That is no small achievement, and you should feel immense pride in your work and in yourselves. You are leaving Bard with a head start on your college education. That is something that few of your peers are able to say. And you are going on to exceptional institutions based on that accomplishment. George Mason University, Delaware State University, Queen's University of Belfast, North Carolina A&T. I was just down there last Friday. They're ready for you. Louisiana State University of Alexandria. Yes. Your leadership in those spaces and beyond will play an important role in our collective future. We are so very proud of you. Graduates, you have made it. And at the same time, you've only just begun with still so much to achieve ahead of you. We cannot wait to see what you are going to write in terms of your next chapter and how your values will lead us all to a better and brighter future in tomorrow. So congratulations, class of 2022.
These are the bittersweet moments, the moments that you realize that you are finally entering a new chapter of life, the moment that you realize you're no longer an early high school college student and fully taking on a new adventure. You have had the amazing opportunity to begin your college journey, which is nothing to take lightly. You have endured the challenges that you face as both a high school and a college student. And you have all earned your associate's degree, placing you in the perfect, placing you in the perfect position to start this next chapter ahead of the curve. I have had the extreme pleasure of getting to know each of you throughout your time at Bard, and I am honored that you chose me to be your faculty speaker. As our second graduating class, you are woven into the beginning pages in the history book of Bard High School Early College DC. As a class, you have been accepted to over 60 colleges, earned over $335,000 in scholarship money, and two full rides among just the eight of you. Let's have a round of applause for that. From your first days entering through the virtual doors of Bard DC, you all have been called the Mighty Eight, our smallest but strong graduating class. Each of you have a fire inside of you that is unique. Keyshell, you have been a leader in your group. You go above and beyond to continuously raise the standard. Davida, you are fearless, strong, and so caring towards others. Keep that energy with you because it's contagious and we need that. Leah, your story is so powerful and such a testament for others who share some of your experiences. Never dim your light to let others shine because your light is incandescent. Sanaya, you have shown yourself what you are capable of. You push past your own doubts and fears, conquering more than you set out to accomplish. Desiree, your dedication to your dreams is inspiring. No matter what space we were in, whether virtual or in person, I know that we could always count on you. Naziah, you are talented in so many ways. This next chapter is going to be an amazing journey of self-discovery and a time to continue to explore all that you bring to the world. Nyla, your entrepreneurial mindset is going to take you far. I can't wait to see what you're bringing and how you continue to grow. Last but certainly not least, Ari, you've persevered through some of the most challenging times. You've created spaces for our community, bonding, and always brought the perfect vibe to set the tone through music. Continue to strive for the best. Together, you are powerful. As each of you take these next steps, remember that starting before you think you're ready is the ultimate faith step. But you have the tools and are equipped to be successful, and that's what matters. Congratulations again, class of 2022. Please join me. Please join me in welcoming Desiree Horn, the class of 2022 student speaker.
Thank you, Dr. Beatty. We made it. We finally did. 4 years. Four years of high school completed. I'm pretty sure we all can't wait to branch off and follow our dreams, wherever our paths take us. 3 years ago, we were all in different areas of the United States, Louisiana, Pennsylvania, Baltimore, and the eight wards of Washington, D.C. In 2020, in the midst of a global pandemic, we all transferred into Bard. At first, we were just names on the screen, and then we met face to face on outdoor field trips, then finally as a whole class in 2021. Even while we worked from home, our teachers were always there for us. During our times in online school, Nellie was always there when it came to trying to give us a real 11th grade experience by planning field trips. She took us to the National Mall for a picnic with Patrick, joined us when we went to the National Women's Museum with Dr. Mike and Dr. Mika. As a class, we have gone through a lot over the past 2 years. This year has been a confusing one indeed. We as a class have felt neglected and forgotten and overall just not heard. The school's only way to make up for that feeling was food. So thank you to all the staff for always buying us food and just always being there for us. This is why I would also like to take the time to thank you all eight of us for pushing through these tough times. I would also like to thank our parents for helping us with FAFSA and supporting us. Thank you to Ms. Upchurch, who was a great help when it came to DC Cap and DC Tag, for always being there when we needed help with FAFSA or just reading college offers, or just overall being there for any questions we had. She also helped me schedule a visit with someone from the international team at the college I'm going to in Ireland. I would also like to thank Dr. Marcille for always being there for me and for helping me edit my book, which is still in the works, and I hope to find a publisher soon. For the second half of my 12th grade year, I was mistaken for a ninth grader on paper, so I should technically be giving this speech to the class of 2025. During my journey at Bard, I've made wonderful friends along the way. Leah and Davida, it's been us three since 11th grade, and we've been through a lot, but our friendship stays strong. And I can't wait to see you guys again during winter break. Bard is a very creative place. We've had fashion shows, Black at Bard, and the Bard Experience. Out of those three things, two of them I was lucky to be a part of as a set designer and an assistant manager. I've never seen a school so open about the arts and more student-led, and I'm glad I've got to experience that my last year at Bard. Mom, thank you for always being there for me during my highs and lows. Thank you for supporting my decision to go to Ireland for 3 years of my life. Also, I would also like to honor my grandfather, who I lost earlier this year. He has always been there for me, from dropping me off at school or picking me up or just getting me pizza or McDonald's on Fridays or just overall being in my life. We are doing something that many people can say they did. We are one of the few who are graduating with a diploma and an associate's degree. We are now going into a new chapter of our lives. We've worked so hard for these past four years. Nothing should hold us back anymore. Nothing should hold us back ever. And congratulations and good luck. Hope to see you all again soon.
Thank you, Desiree. That was beautiful. My name is Stephen Tremaine, and I have the pleasure of serving as Bard College's Vice President for Early College Programs and Executive Director of Bard's National Network of Public Early College High Schools, just like this proud campus in Washington, D.C., which is the newest in that network, and you, the newest set of graduates. I want to underscore, this is not a, traditionally speaking, a large graduating class. Commencements are not typically places for quiet joy, so we're counting on everybody in the room to make sure that the joy is audible when we hand out the degrees after this. If you're in the little big kids set, you're under 5 years old, there are a number of you here, we're counting on you, my friend up front, right? So please let us hear you when we pass out the degrees after this. And I'm happy to point out, it's been said before, but it really bears repeating, this is a stage on which these eight graduates are going to earn two credentials today. This is a high school graduation, and this is a college commencement. Bard DC is a public high school, and it's a branch campus of Bard College, one of the nation's leading institutions of the liberal arts and sciences. So this really is, it's been said before, this is an achievement that really is like few others in the country today. It's also worth pointing out, 100% of you are earning both of those credentials. That's extraordinary. 100% of you are graduating with the associate's degree. The class before you, the first to graduate from the school, 100% of those who went on to college are still enrolled in college, right? So you join a track record of success that we're tremendously proud of on behalf of the college. This is billed as a charge to the graduates. It's the only speech left between you all and the degrees. I'm going to make it really long, Juno. Speeches like this are usually about giving advice. And often advice is not a very fun or welcome thing. We can all agree that sometimes it feels bad to get advice. And we can all agree that some of the most commonly given advice hasn't aged well in these rough last few years. Like this one. We like to tell people, if it doesn't kill you, it only makes you stronger. Especially in light of the last couple years, it may be worth considering that suffering is not a cause of your strength, but rather challenging circumstances reveal your strength. Having started college 2 years early, having done so in the midst of a historic global crisis, two crises, as Secretary Rodriguez pointed out, your strength is self-evident. Further suffering is not necessary. Another piece of advice we get a lot, patience is a virtue. This one, I think, is especially insidious. This is awful advice. We are, in this country, tend to be impatient with small inconveniences. I flew into DC this morning. When they announced my flight was 10 minutes late, you would have thought some great tragedy had befallen everybody assembled there, right? Deeply impatient. But we tend to be patient with injustice. The speed with which your phone downloads a video and the speed with which your society addresses a problem, these call on two very different forms of patience. Let's keep our priorities straight when we decide what we are willing to wait for and what can wait no longer. Justice deferred is justice denied. That's Dr. Martin Luther King, who enrolled at Morehouse College at the age of 15. Not because he finished high school early, but because he didn't want to wait any longer. He didn't want to wait for his turn. He, like you, was an early college graduate. Like you, he showed a virtuous impatience. And I want to honor that today. Here's better advice. Give credit where it's due. Credit is due today to you all, the mighty eight. Early college changes the status quo in education systems, and changing systems requires pressure and proof, and you all are the proof. Credit's due to you for that. Credit's due to you for shifting the narrative about teenagers in this country. I turned 18 while I was still in high school, which meant I could have been entrusted to serve my country in war before I was entrusted to take college algebra. In far too many cities and communities, you can be tried as an adult in a courtroom before you can be treated as an adult in a classroom. Credit is due to you all for changing the narrative around teenagers in this country. So rather than give advice, I would rather take the opportunity to give credit where it's due and say thank you on behalf of Bard College. There's a persistent fallacy in higher education. We too often behave as though people are distinguished by the institutions they attended. I went to Harvard, so I must be special. And the reality is that institutions are distinguished by the people that attended them. Your intelligence, your achievement, and your drive has distinguished Bard, and we are grateful. Today, you become alumni of Bard College, and that status doesn't go away. Your degree doesn't go away. Your education will not go away. Nobody can ever revoke them. There are no liens against them. They are yours clean and clear and forever. You earned them, and they're yours without debt and without a bill. At a time of relentless and often unwelcome change in our society, education confers upon the student things that don't change, things that have permanence. May your pride in what you achieve today be just as permanent. Ours in you will. Congratulations.
Congratulations, class of 2022. Dr. Williams, Mr. Tremaine, Instructional Superintendent Jellig, faculty and guests, it is my pleasure to present the Bard High School Early College District of Columbia class of 2022 for the diploma of Bard High School Early College, along with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto. It is also my pleasure to present the class of 2022 for the degree of Associates in Arts. Their stoles signify the candidates have completed all the requirements for this degree as prescribed by the District of Columbia, the trustees of Bard College, and the faculty of Bard High School Early College. Davida Bonaparte. Leah Cormier. Sanaya Godby. Desiree Horn. Yeah. Naziah Jackson. Nyla Odom, Nyla Odom. Kishel Settle. Ari Cimarins.
President, Vice President Williams, please approach the podium. Before the current conferral of degrees, Dr. Jellig has a few words to say.
Good evening, I'm Dr. J. I'm the superintendent for Bard Early College, and in some degree I have a supervisory role with the school, so I want to start by saying and giving the graduates and their families a heartfelt thank you. I have nothing but gratitude for your patience, for your trust, for your investment. Bard Early College DC has been around for about 34 months. For 27 of those months, we've been in COVID protocols. That was not anticipated, not the ideal way to launch a great enterprise like Bard Early College. And as has been mentioned, along came finally a reckoning with social injustice, and we have confronted that, albeit at a very difficult time. And I just want to acknowledge that while you are small, among your enormous legacies is that you have allowed us to grow and learn and do better. You are like the teacher that showed patience and understanding with the student trying to get it right. And I confront the fact that we will continue to do better. And you will someday, thank you, and you will someday soon, like as in 8 months soon, I hope visit the new Bard, which is your school, and I hope you treat it as such, and we will bring with us the legacy that you have left of patience and understanding and trust. And we can and we will and we must build a great school, a great early college high school in Southeast DC, owing to you and the class before you that have helped us grow institutionally. It's been hard. You've been great. You've been so patient. You've been so trusting to give us your children at a difficult time, citywide, not merely at Bard College. It means the world, and we will not forget it. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
And now, by the power vested in me by the Mayor of the District of Columbia, Muriel Bowser, and by the Chancellor of the District of Columbia Public Schools, Louis Farabee, I hereby certify the 8 members of the class of 2022 have completed the requirements for graduation from Bard High School Early College, DC.
And I, on behalf of Mayor Bowser and Chancellor Farabee, enthusiastically, dare I say nearly as enthusiastically as our parent body, accept the class of 2022 Bard Early College High School on this day, June 23rd, 2022. Congratulations.
So, in a traditional high school ceremony, that will be it, right? We've given these students their high school diploma. But I want to underscore one more time that these amazing young people have done more than just that, and they are all today receiving a college degree. Again, they are receiving a college degree. We are very proud of you. You should be very proud of yourselves. Thank you to the families and the support systems. So the tradition is that Bard College diplomas, as you look at them, they are written in Latin. And there has been an official pronouncement by a representative of Bard College, which is basically to say that by authority vested in me, all the rights and responsibilities of the diploma that you have just received are now yours. So, in Latin, I will read. Auctoritorum mihi commissa, vasa gradum abitus sohi, amito omnica gradia provisia, ad hoc gratum proventia vobis concito, enim testimonium hac diploma vobis concedo tradado. Congratulations, you now have a college degree.
Graduates, please stand. Allow me to present to you the class of 2022 from Bard High School Early College, D.C. You may now move your tassels from the right to the left side of your cap. Congratulations, you are now Bard D.C. alumni. Would everyone please join me in welcoming Councilman Trayon White, who is our next speaker.
To the grade 8, I want to say to you and the family, we're proud of you. I had the opportunity of visiting Bard High School Early College in Baltimore in 2017. And I saw some of the peculiar, smart, brilliant, unique individuals there. And I said, wow, we need something like this in Washington, D.C. And so I talked to the former chancellor and the mayor. And here we are now with our second graduating class. So we're proud of you. We believe in you. Washington, D.C. is the second most degreed place in the United States of America. And so Bard is really giving our youth and young adults a slight edge in our competitive market here. And so we're excited to work. We want to thank the administration, the teachers, the parents, everyone who made this day a special day for you guys. And so on behalf of Washington, D.C., I want to say we love you, we appreciate you, and go do well and make Washington, D.C. proud. Thank you.
Here we are. A highly anticipated moment, but for me, the highly dreaded moment, because this is the point at which I have to let go of you. I have to let go of you as Bard DC students, but but I get to welcome you as Bard DC alum. So this is a new beginning for the Great Eight, our small but mighty class of 2022, who for a full year after transferring in from schools all across the city and beyond, Pennsylvania, Louisiana, Baltimore, you were just team squares to your teachers and to each other. Now, after a year of being back in person, your classmates, colleagues, friends, and family, you have contributed to our legacy of scholarship, have helped to build our fine and performing arts program, have advocated for your fellow students, and made sure that student voice remained at the forefront of the Bard experience. You've also brought fun and community to school by being our resident DJ. Sorry. 100% of you returned to Bard this year. 100% of you have graduated this evening with a high school diploma and an associate's degree. 100% of you will be transferring to four-year colleges and universities next year. And 100% of you will continue to have an impact on the community and world as you did at Bard. You have shown us that big things can come in really small packages and that there's absolutely nothing you can't do. I can't wait to see all that you accomplish. Congratulations, class of 2022. Come back often, and show off. Because I know that I will continue to show you off, Naziah. Thank you all, and I'm so incredibly proud of you.